There's outrage over the Associate Health Minister's proposed freeze on excise tax for tobacco. Casey Costello is facing more questions over any influence from tobacco companies in government policy. She says she doesn't know who wrote a note asking for advice on freezing the tobacco excise tax, which was revealed in a piece by RNZ, with the opposition calling for her to be sacked. Casey Costello was unavailable for this interview this morning, citing her travel to Waitangi, but her opposition was more than happy to chat. Labor's health spokesperson Ayesha Verrall joins us now. Morena, thank you for being with us this morning. Do you believe that the minister doesn't know who wrote that note?
Morena, Jenny. No, it absolutely defies credibility that a minister who gives a note to health officials on a key piece of work that she has underway on smoke-free does not know how a document came to be in her office. I mean, absolutely appalling in the House yesterday when we posed how on earth that question came in to be in her office and passed on to officials, and she had no idea. It's beyond belief.
Now, the minister initially said that she hadn't sought advice about a tax freeze on cigarettes, but official documents obtained by RNZ from the health ministry shows she had. She now says she doesn't know who wrote that request. Do you think that that is an acceptable answer?
Absolutely not. There's two things. Firstly, ministers have to be truthful about their statements, and it does seem like her denial that she gave to Radio New Zealand that she had asked for that advice is incorrect. Secondly, she needs to be able to justify why it is that she is asking for these proposals as a health minister that will be so detrimental to New Zealanders' health, saying things in that document like that nicotine is as harmful as caffeine. Absolutely untrue. How on earth could a person who believes that be someone who could regulate vaping in New Zealand? And secondly, raising a concern that the tobacco industry is on its knees. I mean, why would a Minister of Health concern herself with that? Tobacco is the most harmful product we sell in New Zealand.
OK, so given all of that, is Minister Costello's position as the Associate Minister of Health now untenable? And if so, why?
Because, firstly, ministers absolutely have to be honest, and she has not admitted that she, according to the reporting from Radio New Zealand, has not told the truth. Second, and she hasn't taken multiple opportunities to correct the record. Secondly, it seems like all of these issues were covering up the fact that she was going after a number of tax breaks for the tobacco industry at odds with people's health. Both of these are issues that Christopher Luxon needs to take seriously.
So you believe she shouldn't be the health Associate Health Minister?
That's correct. Firstly, all ministers, as it says in the Cabinet Manual, need to uphold standards of the utmost professional and ethical behaviour. Secondly, New Zealanders expect their Minister of Health to be promoting their health, not doing favours for the tobacco industry.
You don't believe that this is just a case of being a little bit confused, a new minister coming into the government? Is there a case to be heard that she didn't know everything that was in those documents that she handed over, looking for advice on tax excise cuts?
Yeah, obviously we would all be forgiving if, firstly, we saw evidence of her trying to correct the record properly, admitting what she had done wrong. And, you know, a number of National Party ministers, including the Prime Minister, have had to do that in the House. We all get things wrong from time to time. But there hasn't been a clear acceptance of what was the fact that her answers to Radio New Zealand didn't stack up. And secondly, it appears she hasn't really come clean about the purpose of those proposals.
Now, the notes also attacked Labor's record. And I want to quote here, "Our tobacco control measures have had broad and unintended consequences. It has ripped billions of dollars from the poorest and has made many to feel isolated from their communities." And this isn't entirely untrue. So how do you respond to the point that the measures put in place had unintended consequences?
I think the most harmful consequence is that tobacco kills half the people who use it. In getting people to quit, price has been used as a way of doing that in New Zealand. And one of the things that, interestingly, that was introduced by the National Government under John Key and with the Māori Party. But nonetheless, making sure that there are supports for people who are addicted to tobacco and nicotine to be able to get nicotine replacement and move off the smokes is the was at the forefront of Labor's policy. For some people, that is vapes for current smokers to quit. For other people, it's things like patches, support from counselling. I want to take up the point about community isolation in particular. The work that we were doing when in government really focused on making positive environments for people to quit. So for example, in Hamilton, I visited a Pacifica group that was using wakaama to help people who were smoking connect with their culture, do physical activity, and be in an environment that's supported smoke-free. That's the exact opposite of what that note is claiming.
Yeah, so but if evidence does suggest that higher cigarette prices reduces smoking numbers, I want to go back to 2020, where under your government, the annual duty rates of 10% was removed, but what was left was the annual indexation increase in place only. Why did you remove that 10%?
Overall, our policy across the two different components of that complex tobacco tax has been to keep the price of tobacco largely the same in line with inflation, and we do that across those two taxes. We do believe that further increases in real terms would potentially cause more hardship. So the approach we took was making sure that the price didn't go down and making sure people had supports to move off tobacco.
Now, if the tax was removed from cigarettes, what does the evidence suggest would happen to our smoking rates or to our health?
Well, just like any product, we'd see demand for tobacco increase. It would be a tax break and a sales boon for the tobacco industry. And all of that would drive more of the long-term health problems that tobacco causes. So it currently kills 5,000 New Zealanders a year. We're making progress in reducing that, but would see that long tail, long shadow of health harms caused by tobacco, lung cancers, amputations, kidney failure, strokes, heart attacks, for years to come.
Ayesha Verrall, Labor Health spokesperson, joining us this morning. We appreciate your time. Tēnā koe.